Hey everyone, Balint here, and today I'm going to review ActiveChat, which is a fairly new bot builder here in 2019. And if you are familiar with my work, you probably know that I have a good overview of all the bot builders out there, but it's also not the easiest to get me more involved with one of them. And ActiveChat managed this, so let's see what ActiveChat is up to. So they have a visual builder, and I just go and check out some of the things that they offer. So in the same visual builder, you can build up to the three platform as of now. So we focus on Messenger, but you can also do bots for Telegram and SMS with Twilio. And I will show that in the setting later on. And I just wanted to go quickly over all these elements. I picked up a build bot, so it's easier not to waste time on different things here. As you can see, we can use the attributes from Facebook. We can offer quick replies and route the conversation according to their answer. And what I wanted to answer here or add here is that we have the opportunity to send them to a different skill. So these are the skills on the top. As you see, they are like whole conversations. And also we have the little plugins, and we can build up a conversational flow inside the skill with these. So what you can do is send them to a different skill and then also continue the conversation here as well. So you can just subscribe them to different sequences here as well in that way. And you can do the same things with quick replies here. So what I wanted to quickly show you is the call us. If you go here and check the call, you can have different buttons. And actually, it's probably not the best build here, as you can see, because there is a button version here. So if I want to do, I can put this number in here and have people call. And actually, I know the reason for this, because and it's probably not the best format, so it should be like plus one, but I'm not gonna fix that on the fly here. But the reason for that is because it was not available before this option, and it's been a recent addition, and there are so many things that are coming, and that's a good sign that ActiveChat does what they promised to do. And I asked for it, and then a few days later they added it, so that's pretty amazing. As you can see, just quickly about the conditions here, you can, this is the default skill, okay? Let me slow down a little bit. So here, if they type just random words like class, they are redirected to skill whereas classes. So this is when it's like contains. And anytime they type something like, hey, what are the classes? They get redirected to this. And the same with member, and can I call you, for example, that would go that way. Can I join the challenge? And I would go to the challenge. Or I don't find your place, can I get directions, right? And this is a one way of doing it, and that's already quite decent, I would say. But it can lead to confusions, and they have a built-in dialogue flow integration, so you can make it even better with Google's AI. I'm not gonna go into that in detail, but when I go to the bot settings, I will show that quickly. Okay, so one of the limitations, there is no list. Honestly, I don't really use list as of now, so really just sometimes. So that's not a big thing for me. And let me just find if I have somewhere a gallery where I can show. Yeah, this is how a gallery looks like. So it's quite visual, and you can set different things. And at the buttons, if you're familiar with the bot building a little bit, it should help you. Switch, the switch was that one, so it's a condition, NLP, so it's very basic. You connect with, it's not basic, but it's easy to connect with NLP, Google's AI, and intents will be appearing here on the top after connecting. So it will be very easy if it types something, it will be automatically coded by the bot. Another thing I wanted to quickly show you here is the timer. I haven't seen it in other places yet. This is wait until, so you can set it if you're, for example, at a holiday or you just release a course, you can set this timer and you can set, okay, wait until that and that happens, and you can just select the dates as well. So if you're away for a few days, you can set it that way and just have it automatically. So I think that's pretty cool, and you can just duplicate or copy or delete them here, and you can also copy them and put it into another place. So that's also pretty easy and decent. One of the things I don't like much, and it will be changed later on, that I just cannot create a new block or plugin here, and also connecting things. It's not always the easiest, as I just managed it for the first time now, like you see. So as of now, it's not the easiest, but it's going to be fixed very soon. I requested the change for a while, so let's hope for that. And I can even use the keyboards to delete. There's no limitations here with the listen. I wanted to show that you have all the button options with the quick replies, so you can ask for an address, an email, a phone number, and have the Facebook suggestions already there. And you can use these attributes later on. It's very powerful. One of the things they also offer is that they have built-in timers. So if I go here and show you quickly that they have the date already in, so you can use that. You can say hey, good afternoon even, or like, hey, happy Sunday, whatever that is. So that's pretty powerful, and you get all these attributes from them as well. And I don't know if anything here. There's an email, so if you have a lead and you want to send it to your email address or have some summary for the previous conversation, you can easily send to an email to yourself. Or if you want to send email to the client or put them on a list, you can use the JSON block, and basically that would, I don't know why it's not available here right now. I think, oh, it's available. It's just so, yeah, that's one of the design changes that needs to be done. Like, it's it's hard to catch, or like you have the feeling that it's not active. Yeah, so you can just send data to for example, to Zapier or MailChimp or wherever you want to. It probably needs a little bit coding, or you use Integromat or Zapier, as I usually suggest. And there are cart integrations. This is really powerful. So actually, let me just jump on to the cart integration, but I just wanted to quickly show you in the backend as well, or in the front end. No, I'm going to do that from the settings, because there are the grow tools as well as many other things. So let's just go to the persistent menu. Yeah, you can set that up and create the different items here, submenus, as you already know. So these are the sandwich menus that you can have on Messenger. And one of the things I wanted to show here is the integrations, okay? So this is really powerful, because you can just get your API token from Dialogflow, put it here in the connect, and yeah, that's it. After that, all the intents will be appearing here. And you will also have the possibilities with the contexts and seeing the in and out and entities. It's a little bit too much for this video to talk about that, but it's super powerful. If you want to make a cleverer bot and not just like, oh, sorry, I didn't understand that, but you see so many times, and this is really powerful, and this can help a lot, and you can utilize and leverage Google's AI. And if you have a shop, then WooCommerce and Shopify integrations are also just that easy. And what you can do is just connect it here and get all your products be imported into the chatbot. So I will talk about that later, but that's super powerful. And here are some upcoming integrations. About the messengers, there are currently three platforms. So Facebook Messenger, Telegram, and Twilio. Google Home and Amazon Alexa is coming, I believe, in March. And also WhatsApp was announced just a few days ago. So that's also coming this spring. And I wanted to just go over to Broadcast. Broadcast is quite limited as of now. It's going to be better, as promised to me. So here you can set different skills that you have. So it's very easy in a way. You can just utilize the skills you already have and you can reuse it, and there will be some data shown as well. So I can just send the broadcast actually just as a test now. So let's send the start, and I cannot filter here. I could filter in the skill, so it's not that difficult, but that needs to be improved a little bit, to be honest. And I'm just sending it to myself now. So you can see it's sent to two users, and I already have it appeared here. So ActiveChat demo messaged me, and yeah, here I have the start. So I can just say, okay, let me get on this program, and all the automation goes. And about the grow tools, there are three here listed. There is a fourth one. I don't know why it's not visible here now, but basically it's really cool with the chatbot, the chat plugin. You can choose your color, so you can set your brand colors, and you can also set it to the different versions, like how you want to welcome the people. You can even delay it, so you don't overwhelm them at the beginning. And you probably just show it like 5 seconds later. That's really powerful, and I like it. That's better than one of the things I've seen. And you can have a landing page built by ActiveChat. I'm not a big proponent of that. If you have a proper business, you want to use your website, but it's an extra help for you. And the messenger code is really cool here as well, so people can scan it. You can use Facebook ads as well. You can use the referral for this. There is a good help section, so you can see all the information listed there about Facebook ads as well. And if you want to do the e-commerce thing for your shop, yeah, the categories are explained there, for example. But let's go just Facebook ads. Here you can see how you can create the targeting and everything and setting up. Okay, I don't know if I'm anything tracking. Oh my gosh, this is so powerful. So you can track your visits on the website. So people who use your chatbot go on your website, and there is this little code snippet on your website, like a Facebook pixel. So you can collect that information and use it and message them later. So that could be really powerful to know which customers have checked out that and that site. I'm really stoked about that. And if you have an e-commerce store, then it's especially powerful. Stats, you have usage stats broke down into different platforms. For me, it's only Facebook Messenger that is collected, so that's what you can see with all my test users. I just wanted to say here, you can see the conversation here as well, but there will be a live chat later on available as well. As of now, it's still missing. I believe it's coming next month already. And here you can see all your attributes or variables. So you can just add them here as well. So you can see if they missed the class or they signed up for the class or whatever things you want to filter on. And you can also just check what they bought in your shop or something like that. Okay, I believe I've went over everything I wanted here. And sorry for the rush, it's just I don't want, there's so many things I don't want to make this video so long. So two things I wanted to talk about is the pricing and the support. So the support is very good. As all growing companies, they need to take some time sometimes. So it can be one day till they answer, but the answer is helpful. There is a Facebook group and you can just ping people if there is anything missing, but so far it's pretty good. And about the pricing, there is a free option. It's a little bit limited to 500 people and in the functions as well. The starter is 19 per month and you can send out the broadcast, see the conversation history. I believe the live chat will be available here as well. But where it really got interesting is the architect and the agency plan. And here with the architect, you can connect to multiple platforms and use SMS as well, for example. Also, you can connect your e-commerce store and use the site tracking. So the site tracking alone like can make the price back very easily, in my opinion. And the reason I said it's good for agencies besides the e-commerce stores is that there's a white label solution coming out. And also you can get easily cheap bots here and resell it to other people and say that it's your tool because it's white label. So you, instead of ActiveChat, you would have your own brand when they go in and try to send their broadcasts, for example. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you liked it. And just wanted to let you know, I managed to secure a discount code for every one of my listeners and followers. So if you put this code in and you can see it here in the screen or in the comments below, you will get 15% off in the first year. And please don't share it anywhere else. I promise that I will just use it for my followers. And another good news is that ActiveChat will be rolling out an affiliate program, and I think you can already sign up here. And that way you can earn some money extra when you have clients or just refer it to friends. Let me know how it goes for you and see you in my next video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. Thank you very much. Bye.